This video will demonstrate the SAS 9.4 Advanced Programming Performance-Based Exam. We are looking at the introduction of the exam, which will help you become familiar with the exam environment before the exam timer starts. We have a series of tasks on the left and our exam environment on the right. You may see a menu at the bottom about cookies. You can dismiss that message. Looking at the first introduction task, we're going to focus on the menu bar at the top of the screen. This will allow you to adjust the screen resolution. You can choose to select a specific resolution, or there's also a Fit to Window button that will make the screen take up all the available space. With that set up, let's now look at the second task, where we're going to start SAS Software. I'm going to choose to start SAS Studio, but if you prefer to use Enterprise Guide or SAS Display Manager, those are available as well. I'll start to adjust the size of the window to make the most of the available space. And if you haven't seen our Base Programming Specialist introduction video, I'd recommend taking a look at that, because we do have some good pointers about ways to minimize the need to scroll during your exam. Now we're going to take a look at the third task, which is going to make sure the keyboard is configured correctly for you. The lab defaults to an English-US keyboard configuration, but if your hardware is different, you will want to make some changes. This will start with the menu bar at the top. We'll go up and select the keyboard icon. And let's say that we were in Sweden. We would adjust the keyboard layout to Swedish. And then we're going to make sure that the user interface is selected. We don't want it grayed out. We want to click it so that it's highlighted and active. And then we're going to come to the bottom menu and select the keyboard configuration here and also set it to Swedish. This will ensure that characters such as semicolons and quote marks, which are important to programming, will display correctly. You should test with some practice code at this point and make sure that the settings are correct, and then adjust the two menu options that we adjusted to ensure they're working well. Now, in some test sites in Nordic countries, need an extra step for Alt-GR key sequences. This is for a few special characters, such as backslash and dollar sign, and only required if the Alt-GR physical key isn't working. In this case, you can go up to the keyboard menu on the menu bar and select Show Keyboard. This will display a soft keyboard where you can activate the Alt-GR key and then click to type a backslash or a dollar sign, for example. Again, this is only for a small number of characters, and only if the Alt-GR physical key isn't working for you. I'm going to switch it back now to the US English configuration, because that's what I am using here at my desk. I'll wipe out the code that I wrote, and we'll move on to the next task. Now, if you're familiar with the Base Programming Specialist exam, you know that you write code, and on that exam, you would answer questions to provide answers to your exam. In this one, it works a little differently. You still write code, but rather than answering questions, you're simply going to run a macro that we call ScoreIt to evaluate your results. This macro will do a few things. First, it's going to reset the environment to a baseline configuration. Then it's going to verify that your program was saved to the correct location. If not, it will generate a message telling you to check the name and location of the file to see if you matched what the instructions indicated. Then it's going to run your program and finally evaluate your program. It will do this with two checks. First, it checks the results to ensure that you solved the programming challenge correctly. This may be looking at an element of the data set or a specific parameter such as a macro variable value. Second, it looks at the program itself to ensure that the proper techniques were used. For example, if the question specified to use the SQL procedure, the checks will look for important keywords to demonstrate that procsql was used to solve the problem and not simply coded with data step. Then the macro is going to return a code that will identify if you solved the problem correctly. You'll record this code as your answer. For security purposes, these codes are dynamic and change frequently. Never provide a code that wasn't generated by the macro. One final point is that the libraries on this exam are created for you automatically when you start SAS. You do not need to create the libraries from scratch. Now let's see this in action. We're going to move on to the sixth introduction task, which is going to have us open the score.sas program. And we'll leave this program open for the duration of the exam. This contains the SCOREIT macro. And then we'll see it in action with an example. So this is a very simple example of how the programming projects will work during your exam. We're just going to follow the instructions here, and it tells us that we want to save the program as a specific file, TST01, in a certain folder. So we'll go ahead and save the program in the correct folder with the correct name. That same folder will be used for all of your programming projects. And then we're going to follow the instructions. In this case, we're just doing a very simple creation of a data set from the sashelp.cars data set. Just a simple concept to demonstrate how this is going to work. We're going to save the program. Anytime we edit the program, we want to resave it. That's important. At this point, we're doing a pre-check. We're going to check the log, check the results, see if things are behaving the way that we intended. It's a fully functioning version of SAS, so you're able to check your log and troubleshoot. Now we're going to go to the score.sas program, find the SCOREIT macro, and look in the instructions for a specific parameter. For this project, that parameter is TST01. And then we're going to run that. We're able to go into the log and look at what the macro did. So we can start at the top and see that it first restored settings to default. It then submitted the program. We can see the log from the program run. And then we have the section where it evaluates the program and results and returns a response code, in this case, 123. So we transfer that 123 to the exam. Now, for security purposes, these codes are dynamic and they change frequently. Never provide a code that wasn't generated by the macro. Now we can look at the case of the program if it was incorrect, and in this case, if we had just used the wrong source data set. And we save the program. It's always important to save the program every time before you submit the macro. Now we're going to resubmit the macro. And let me reiterate that it's important to run that macro from a separate program, in this case, score.sas, then your source program, because it calls your program. If you tried to run it from within your program, you'd end up with recursion. You'd end up in a big loop. So always run it from the score.sas program. And we can see in this case, with it incorrect, it returned a different response code. Okay, so that is the major part of this demonstration video. A couple little points to wrap up with. We can see that documentation is available during the exam. It's available as a shortcut on the Internet Explorer toolbar. It's also set as the home page for Internet Explorer. So if you were to open Internet Explorer from the icon on the desktop, it would open up to the documentation page. Now, it isn't the fastest documentation. We don't recommend that you rely on it too heavily, but it is there if you get stuck on a specific function or formula. The final two pieces in the introduction are just some comments about the specific form of the exam, what to expect in terms of number of projects, and then finally, just a little wrap-up statement. So thanks for watching the video, and good luck on your exam.